Oh yeah, she's back. Oluwaseun, thank you, Adedoyin. A lovely morning, darling. In the name of Jesus, hallelujah. Hallelujah. Thank you so much. Thank you. Pretty you guys coming on one by one. Pretty you all guys. Let's look at names. Welcome back, darling. Thank you. I'm charging at the same time. Well, the iPad has soared it to the 0% charging. Dickness, all of you are just so quiet online. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. I did, to be honest with you. I do as minimal I can do in Nigeria. You know, I actually do. You know, I do really have good time here. I won't lie about that. Thank you. Back to work, back to reality. Back to work, back to reality. Good morning. Welcome back. Thank you. Thank you, ma'am. Thank you. Ajia Bola Sali, thank you for coming on, for joining us. Mm-hmm. It is not my power, but by His grace. It can only be God. Every journey we undertook in life, we have to understand one thing in our mind. That is not by our power, but by His grace. Everything that we do on planet is ordained. And if it is not ordained, yes, we will not be here today. I want to appreciate you all. I want to thank you. Give me a second, because I'm on YouTube at the same time. You know, I want to appreciate you guys all the time. Ope lo nje re ko si oruko miran ti o ba se pe ope ope fun alawura bi oba to seda eniyan ope fun ibori aye ato ba daye ma jaroro olorun to seda eniyan bibire o se fowora. I am grateful to you all, and I'm grateful to God Almighty who creates my destiny for me. I will not step on toes, but I don't want anybody to disturb my journey for me. I love God, and I'm trying to play by God's rule. Anything that happens in life is by His power. I didn't go to any place by mistake, and I didn't do anything by chance or mistake. It's written in the diary from heaven. So what I'm trying to do is just to follow that diary and see how far I can go. The stories of coming in and out, people are saying, I don't really understand that. But I want people to continue to enjoy my world. I want to appreciate you all for your support throughout the time I was in Nigeria. I want to thank you for all the viewers. I want to thank you, all of you, the clients, the fans, the viewers, the bypassers, you know, because we have different people. We have the clients, we have the introducer, we have the godfather and the godmother that are silent, that are not talking and introducing people to me and say, go to her. I trust her, I believe in her. kudos to you, most especially those two who are so silent with British passport but still sending people down and say go to the lawyer to Kumba's office. I believe and trust in her. I want to say kudos to you all guys for all those viewers, those who are bypassing, who just go by, and to those who come in by accident, I appreciate you all. Nothing is by accident on the world. When you come there, it is written, it is ordained. So you should have that in mind. I love you guys. I love your support. Your support is invaluable. When I was in Nigeria, when I come online, the moment my guys put my profile online and I see your names coming up, I feel so, so overwhelmed with joy. I feel overwhelmed with joy. I have to be honest with you. Anyone that says that their fans are not important, it's a deceiver. That person is deceiving herself or himself. Fans are important. Fans are crucial in your journey. You see, I cannot explain how much I love you guys individually, and I see names coming up all the time, and those names are so sticked into the brain. I cannot forget you guys. I appreciate you. I want to thank you all from the bottom of my heart for your full support online throughout. Some people did not leave line throughout my ordination. They were online watching the sermon, the songs, everything. I want to appreciate you. I want to thank you. You are so invaluable. I want to appreciate the Christ Victory Church members. I want to thank you, every one of you, including my beautiful pastor. You guys are wonderful. You are so human, and you are very friendly and lovely. I love you all. You only know why you chose me, and nobody need an answer to that. Keep it to yourself. May God continue to help us to sail through. We are in a journey. I pray that both you and I will sail through to the glory of God in the name of Jesus. You have decided to choose me as your matron, Christ Victory Church, Wonderland in Mushi, and I promise you that I will not let you down. I will try all my best in my capacity. I am not a loud person, apart from my public work. But I know that I will try my best at the end of the day for you. You know, I'm on live program, Diola. I'm on live program. Yeah. I want to appreciate them so much. I want to thank you fans as well. I want to thank the Lagosians. And I want to thank my friends Londoners. Auntie Shadi Odunaye, you are such a genuine person. Fola Shadi Odunaye, you are such a genuine person. There is no imitation of you. So whoever moves with you, whatever they see is what you are. You are just like me. You are just like me. There is nothing hidden. I saw you in my hotel room. I saw you in church. I saw you in my sitting in the same car with me. I saw you beside me. I saw you partying in the front of the church when I was entertaining my guests. I saw you enjoying your life. I saw you when we were doing Thanksgiving on that ordination day. I believed that is how human beings should be. Just follow your destiny the way it is. Just be yourself. Personality. Show your personality to the world. Don't be somebody else's. Auntie Shadi Odunaye, you have shown me that you are a human being. You have shown me that you are a real person. Call me one time. I will answer you 30 times, Auntie Shadi. I promise you from my heart. It's a promise. You call me one time, Auntie Shadi, Fola Shadi Odunaye, I will answer you 30 times. Because you shocked me. So also, Mr. Shina Alimi. You shocked me as well, Mr. McDean. You shocked me. Yetunde Fashi, Shegun Oriluwa Benson. All of you shocked me. You shocked me beyond my belief. You shocked me, you know, Ibukun, all of you. You shocked me beyond my comprehension of status. You made me believe that Eniyan Shalashomi. No matter how big your status is in life, if you lack people in your with your status, you are nobody. You are nobody. Ọlọ́run ní agbára lórí ènìyàn tó bẹ́ẹ̀ gẹ́ tó ṣe pé ó fi ènìyàn ṣe ike ara wa ni ó fi àwọn èèyàn surround ara wa. And when you underrate people or you underestimate people, it's your losses. Ènìyàn Láṣọ́mi, I want to appreciate all of you. I want to thank you so, so much from the bottom of my heart. The pastors at Christ Victory Church Wonderland, you are all invaluable. My general overseer, you are so tremendous. You have proven to me that there is something we call real people. And I've seen it that there are real people. There's still real people in life. I want to love you all, guys. I want to tell you that I will always be there anytime you need me. I will not turn my back to you. Christ Victory Church, I stand gallantly as your matron. And I promise you today, this day, 20th of September 2017, I stand gallantly as your matron. I won't go off. You know, I won't go off. Nothing will make me shake. By the power of the authority that has been anointed inside me from my mother's womb, I stand behind your back. You will always see me when you need me. I will not let you down. I want to welcome you all one by one. Bola Omiyale JP, Mama, I love you so much for all the support you have been giving online. You've never been away. Regina Obalana, I want to thank you. Elijah Akipelu, I want to thank you, all of you, one by one. If I see your name coming up, I will mention it because I saw you full-time online on that day. Appreciation is my English. Appreciation is my swagger. And that over while I hear it about Mokwe, there are Kumonuroni, and Toban Ronu, Oman Dupeni, Okwefu Allah Rabi Oba Mimo, Okwefu and Toshe Daini, Buria Yatio, Okwefu Allah Obatoniwa, Obatoni Oketoni Le, Okweni Boba, Olo Loja me, only thank you, I want to appreciate you. I appreciate God in your life. I thank God for your family. I thank you all of you. All of you, I thank you. Names, if you are coming up, I will mention you. I will mention you, Adoron Kebadero. Thank you so much. Thank you. Thank you. I want to thank you all for being there all the time. You know, I want to show my appreciation. It's tremendous. I must be honest with you. It's tremendous. It's tremendous. You know, sometimes in life, things get to a stage that you believe that it is not by your power anymore. So you have to release your guard. I've always been a private person to myself, but at certain stage in life, the journey has taken me from far to east, south to west to north, and to make me realize that I am not myself alone anymore. I wasn't born for myself. I was born for public at large to serve, and at any time I am willing, I am ready to serve. May God help us all. I want to thank you, Emmanuel. Hello, good morning, and welcome back. Thank you. Thank you. Adiola Father Ero, good morning, my girl. Good morning to you. Welcome. Yeah. Yes, I want to appreciate you all. It was fantastic. It was fantastic. And I thank God both on the air and on the land, you know, locally and internationally. I appreciate God. And I appreciate you people because Eniola showed me. But I believe and trust, and I still trust in I trust and I believe, so I won't change. It's good to be yourself rather than to be somebody else's. Princess Adiola Nurat Durosimi, good morning to you. Thank you for coming on. I couldn't have the better time to do it. That's why I quickly want to do it this morning, because I am going into a deep, busy period. My desk are so dirty with files, you know. I don't care, can be. Thank you, my darling. Thank you. You know, I have so much to cover. So much to cover. But I think this morning will be the better morning for me to do it. Good morning to you. Biola Sadu, thank you so much. Thank you. Thank you for all your tremendous support. It's invaluable. It's not in the market to buy. It's not purchased. There's no money that can buy that support you have given me while I was in Nigeria, when I was filming on Atimushi in Solo Road, when I was doing all sorts of things. You were there assisting and telling me, may God continue to bless you. People were even telling me to close up my location, not to give the last minute step-ins. People were giving serious advice, and they were very serious about it. Good morning, Mr. Ekene, do not miss. Please, you will reach me. I'll tell you now, don't worry. Thank you so much. Thank you for your all support. Thank you. I bless God in your life. I bless God in your family. I soak you in the blood of Jesus. I speak by the authority. Yes, Alaji Tajudin Ashanti. Ishola, thank you, sir. Thank you so much. Sheun Tunde, good morning, my dear. Good morning. Omobade Dayo Kayode, I like your Yoruba accent. Thank you so much. Thank you. Thank you. I'm trying my best. You know, I grew up in Yoruba land, so don't forget about that. So I love Nigerian as a whole. Experience is vital. Emma de Casoleno, don't let us lost hope on Nigeria. Nigeria is a better place to live. I will share experience with you today. Today is about sharing my experience Amen. Mr. Sheuntunde, thank you. May God continue to bless all of us and continue to protect us and order our steps. Thank you so much. Thank you, thank you, thank you. I want to share experience with you. I met a young lad when I was flowing back into the country. He's a Taiwan citizen, a Taiwan national. The guy made me realize that everything is in Nigeria now. That the whole world is not getting tired. So the economy is now moving to Nigeria. That's the young lad's speech. He sat next to me in the aircraft. So the young guy made me realize, Mr. Wole Omidiji Oloto joined. Thank you, sir. Thank you. Idera Nwafo, good morning. Kudos to you for all your good work. Thank you, Mr. Idera Nwafo. Thank you. Thank you, Prince Wole Omidiji. Thank you for joining us. Thank you, everyone, for coming on one by one. You know, it's a great honor and privilege to be your lawyer, to be your friends, to be your somebody that you love. Please bear with me. It's my personality and I cannot change. That's what made me stand out among other lawyers. I do some things differently. From day one, people know me. Good morning to you, Oluwa Tomi Kafayat. Thank you so much. Morning, my dear. You know, I stand out in the way that I do public work. So my work take me differently from other lawyers. Apart from being an advocate of the Supreme Court of England and Wales, I do things differently. And that is how you should do it in life. When too many people are doing the same thing, you need to look for a way out to stand out, to do things differently. Because I get bored with things all the time, same things. I get bored. You know, if you don't know me, you have to start listening to me because I get bored. You know, repeating myself all the time makes me tired in brain. My brain needs something very challenging, needs something different. So that is why I do public speaking. That is why I deviate. I give seminars on immigration. I do it on child, on family, on relationship, on this, on that. Because I love to do things challenging. I love to do things differently. I cannot afford to get stuck in one place. Nobody can make me get stuck. I am not a person that can get stuck. I get fed up. I get tired, you know, so I cannot get stuck in one place. I want to appreciate you. I want to thank you. But the experience I want to share is that the guy sat next to me on the aircraft. We started chatting and talking, and it made me realize that Nigeria is the next phase of economy in the world. And I saw it myself, how people are moving forward. But what he said to me is that you need a trusted alliance on ground. Because if you don't have trusted person on ground, you're going to get stuck. You're going to get stuck. That is the problem. If you don't have trusted person on ground, you're going to get stuck. So the situation is that you have to have somebody that you can trust to do business with in Nigeria. Nigeria is such an intelligent nation. The difference is clear. Toshuoma, exactly. You understand? Nigeria is such an intelligent nation. And having said that they are intelligent, it's true, the intelligence is what you need to pick up what you will need to move on with your own journey. But then having said that, you have to have your ears on ground and be intelligent as well. Because if you're not wise enough, you'll be caught up by the intelligence in Nigeria. Because it's a country. Sarah Mide, how are you? How are you? And Shegun Olu Komaya, Ana Komaya. Good morning, darling. Good morning. It's such a country that they are so eager to make it in life. Every individual in Nigeria is hungry for success. So it is in Nigeria that you have 419. An average of Nigerian wants to make money overnight. An average of Nigerian wants to make money overnight. So you have to be at alert. You have to be wary of them. If you're not wary of an average of Nigerian that wants to make money overnight, you'll be deceiving yourself. And if you want to run business in Nigeria and you think you're not a flying person, don't try it. Because you have to be able to fly in and out, in and out, in and out, in and out. If you're not a risk taker, if you're just 9-to-5 person, matter me similar cooking, don't do business in Nigeria and live in England. You will never make one penny from it. If you are one of those that says, Mata Misimilara, mi ufe dodo, I just want to sit on my comfortable desk. Don't use your money to set up business in Nigeria because you will live to regret it. But if you are one of those who is ready for go and get it, then Nigeria is a place for you to venture in. Do you see what I mean? I need your WhatsApp. You're right, man. Honestly, if you are just somebody that loves your 9 to 5, go to work conservatively, return home, no noise, nothing. That is what I used to be in those days. In those days, I was 9 to 5 those days. You know, even while I was at law school, over here, don't forget I did everything in England, apart from my primary and secondary school in Nigeria. As soon as I've returned back, you know, I've put things in place. I used to be 9 to 5. So 9 to 5 means that I go to work when I was working with the sensitive government department, which I'm not ready to mention. You know, so I go to work 9 to 5 and I'm very wary of the department so that government doesn't start watching me and see what I do. So I basically only travel to Nigeria once in 1 year and probably once in 2 years, Seth. I've even traveled to Nigeria once in 5 years. Isn't it funny? Yeah, I have traveled to Nigeria once in 5 years before, you know. But what I want you to understand is that as time goes on, after law school and being in practice, then I start realizing who I am, that I am not a person that can sit in one place. Because I begin to be so uncomfortable why I am in one place and I don't travel, I don't do things differently, I get tired, I get fed up, I get irritated. I invite my dear Agbo. Thank you, darling. Florence Ipemet, you are the best. Welcome back and thank God for your joining us. Yes, Miss Florence Ipemet, thank you so, so much for your full support online. Your full support is tremendous, it's invaluable. Miss Ipemet, all the comments, everything I saw, you are wonderful. Florence Ipemet, Florence Ipemet, madam, you are wonderful. I cherish you, madam. I love you dearly. I have not met with you, but I know one day we will definitely meet each other. Moreni Kemutunrayo, Anna Musuakinwande, you are all fantastic. Miss Ipemet, I love you dearly. I have not met with you, but I love your support online. Your support is invaluable. You are just having you online means that I have my back watching. I love your reply, your response. Without being arrogant, I love all the responses that you have given to people on my behalf. I don't have to fight my battle anymore. When I see you online, I see my God. I am so, so, so humble. I love you dearly, madam. I love you. So let me continue what I am saying. I used to be 9 to 5 and get bored sitting in one place. But after some times, I realized that that is not what the destiny has in bucket for me. So I start changing my style bit by bit, bit by bit, bit by bit, bit by bit, bit by bit. And during my traveling to Nigeria, in and out, I encounter some people both strong and strong-headed on the aircraft, on ground, everywhere. Most especially females, some males as well. Who told me that this is how life should be in Lagos, not Ibadan, not elsewhere. So from there on, I begin to move on. When I recruit some staffs into my office then, those staffs were invaluable. They were the ones that introduced me to media work. So I started my media advice. I started doing the media. From there, they started calling me from church to come and speak. That is why I will always have respect for all the celestials in this country, the cherubim and the redeemed. Those are the people that have been calling me so far. The celestials, the cherubim, and the redeemed. Those three denominations of churches believe so much in me. Celestials, K&S, and redeemed. They always call me and ask me to come and put what is in my mind out there. Please just pour out a bit of what is in your heart, in your belly. So I always answer them, I do that. And then I set up office in Nigeria because I needed something that would be taking me to Nigeria very, very often. So I set office in Nigeria. And from there, I began to move from one place to another. I've always had offices in Nigeria, so that is not a problem. You know, ever since I stepped into the country, my parents have watched my back for both myself and my husband. So they have helped us to build houses in Nigeria that nobody go to Britain and come back and sleep in family's house again. So they've covered our back in that area. But then when we have the time ourselves, we started doing things on our own and started building and started buying, you know, in our own time as well. But what I want you to appreciate most is that you need people that you can trust in Nigeria before you do anything. Don't send money to anybody in Nigeria unless you are ready. There are some things that I'm supposed to do in Nigeria that I went, but my heart says no, not yet. So I didn't put money on it. My heart, my spirit says no, Don't try it now. You have enough in your pocket to take care of. Finish all what you have put in your hand before you start another headache for yourself. I get bored, like I said to you. I don't care about the headache and people calling me here and there and challenges. You see, not this journey. There are some two journeys I've made so far to Nigeria, and I want to share it with you at the same time. That is why you have to be wary of people that you deal with. It doesn't matter whether the person is a lawyer in Nigeria. You really need to trust that person or ex-state agent. Because I encounter issues, not this journey, but about two or three previous journey. I bought some flats in Nigeria, and those flats that I bought were bought in GRA. It happens that the seller and the estate agents have connived together, and the seller is supposed to be a legal practitioner who's supposed to hold the Nigerian Bar Association so high on top. But unfortunately, he seized my document after collecting more than quarters of the money. And I only left with small change for him to pick up in England. Only 4.5 million for him to pick up in England. He didn't come to England to pick up the money. He was going to seize my property in Nigeria. He released one, he seized the other, he seized the document for the other one. But before he realized the property that he seized the document, I put tenants inside that property straight away. I asked again to put tenants in the property with immediate effect. So I take complete possession of that property without even completing the payment, because he has seized the document and refused to accept the balance of money from me. So we went into litigation in Nigeria. I took a very good and buoyant lawyer who stand before any judges without fear in Nigeria. So I asked him to go and represent me in Nigeria. I paid him good money. So he went into suit, and with the help of all my friends and families and prayers there. So the case went ahead, and we were successful. And at the end of the day, you will realize that you just think that I have nobody in Nigeria, that I am a kata. That's why the guy wants to play the game. Because at the end of the day, what happened is that when the mediator asked us what does he want from me, he couldn't even say, other than asking me to pay the money he has paid on the security and the money he has paid to lodge the document. So my lawyer was going to argue with him that I'm not going to pay. I said to the lawyer immediately that go and accept that offer and get my document from the bastard. Excuse my French. So you need to know people that you want to deal with in Nigeria. Nigeria is not a place that you can just play anyhow. You've got to really have your mind on ground. If you are not ready, don't put money on ground. I end up taking my documents and my things from that seller. But the seller is supposed to be a lawyer, a member of Nigerian Bar Association. But it was a disgrace to the core of NBA. Like I saw that I saw on that day, I saw him as a disgrace. Because that's what my lawyer took as a chance against him. I said, listen, you have disgraced Nigerian Bar Association. You have disgraced the Supreme Court in Nigeria because you are a lawyer. She trusted you. She's a lawyer of another jurisdiction. She came to Nigeria, she trusts you. And that is why she put things in your care. And you seize document and you refuse to release keys. But we took control of things with the help of God in the end, because I don't care spending money when something belongs to me. I will fight it to the end. So because I don't practice law in Nigeria, I use lawyers in Nigeria to do that jurisdiction, and we were successful. The warning I want to give to my friends and families and fans there is that be wary of people that you want to deal with in Nigeria. Nigeria is not a country that you can just play neat with, like England. England is tick, 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 tick. Yeah, England is tick, 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 tick. But in Nigeria, it is not tick, tick, tick. So you have to be wary of that. Yeah. People, yeah, bloody thieves, that's what they do, yeah. So you have to be wary of those situations. You cannot afford to let people just dupe you anyhow in Nigeria. You just have to make sure that you have your mind at alert. So what I want to advise you on is that before you put money down, make sure you have someone you can trust. Full trust. I'm not saying just trust of one day or 2 days. Full trust. If you don't have someone that you can trust, you're going to waste your money. Could I see a lot part of my before? There's no police that will fight you. There is no that you can fight. There is no judge that will stand for you. There is no one to assist you, in a nutshell. Anyway, so the advice is that ensure that you have trusted alliance on ground. Don't go to Nigeria without knowing where you are going to stay. You need to check your location carefully. You see, everything is about class and status. You need to know your location, where you are going to stay. You understand? I don't want to go through the issue of security. Where is security today? Where is generator? Where is for now? I don't want. So you just have to be, you have to be wary of those kind of things, because if you don't manage to understand situation on ground, it's going to be very difficult. It's going to be very difficult. Nigeria is not an abomination place for us to go. If you have the opportunity to travel, I guess you should visit Nigeria and see what you can do in Nigeria. If you have papers, don't say goodbye to Nigeria, because it's a country of origin, and there is no way you can leave your country of origin. No way. Omoto so ilenu o so apo ya koni. It is better to start doing it. I saw you on. It is better to start doing it bit by bit. You know, bit by bit, bit by bit, bit by bit, bit by bit, bit by bit. So that you can then, you know, you can get yourself familiarized with it. You have to be doing it bit by bit. Don't say goodbye to your country of origin. Because I have met with people that says they will never go back to Nigeria. Don't do that. You're welcome on, my sister. I love you guys. Take life easy, okay? I saw you there. Take life easy. I said it. Take life easy. I don't want to mention your name, but I want you to take life simple. Take it easy. Ignore people. Pretend as if you never heard or you never see. Practice it and it will work well for you. It will move you on smoothly. Trust me. So I want to thank you, everybody. So what I'm saying is that don't say you don't want to go to Nigeria anymore. Don't say you want to ignore Nigeria. Nigeria is not a country to ignore. Trust me. It is not a country to ignore. Don't let anybody deceive you. Benny, Ilela Bosimioko, no place like home. No matter how long we can stay in England, you see, this visit that I made, I feel so overwhelmed to the extent that I actually really want to stay more. But I get tired. After a few days, I always get tired. But I guess I will get used to it as time goes on. That's why I always go in and out quickly, so that I don't miss out with it, you know. And if you travel very often, believe me, you get used to the system. You get used to everything around it. You get used to the flying. You get used to everything, you know. I will not deny you that. I will advise, I will continue to encourage people. Don't lose hope about Nigeria. Don't lose hope. It is a place that you must always have at heart. It is a place. I love you, Omolagbaye, Engineer Leo. I love you. I throw my heart. I am humble. You know, I love you so much. Omaru, Omalale, Omalale, Ategejo, Ogbere, Ategaragara. Olawa Jori, Aruju, Tomu, Shikoshu, Fuloke, Shamu, Bokite, Araole. I love you dearly. Seeing you alone is more than enough. I love you. You are a Christian. So I am. So I love you so much. It's only the word, you know, the faith of heart that we can use to love each other. If you are not really truthful person, you cannot love people dearly without reservation. When you are truthful to yourself, you don't look about people's mistake or people's other thing. You just want to love them naturally. I love you. I will find time to see you next time when I come. I will come to you, whether in Abuja or Lagos. I will not care about flying to see you. I will definitely trace you back. Trust me. So I want to continue to encourage people. And that's what I said, that yes, you know, we must try to visit home. Don't leave Nigeria as a place of abomination. God forbid. Nigeria is not a place that you cannot go if you have papers to travel. I beg of you. It is not a place that you cannot go. I beg of you. Do not ignore your country of origin. Do not ignore your country of origin. It is very important. But when you are going, you need to know the people that will come and meet you at the airport. You need to know the people that will be driving your car, the person that will drive you around. You have to have your location where you are going to be staying. Let me tell you good advice. Don't say you want to stay in family house. You have worked tirelessly in the cold weather here. Please take your money aside and book hotel and enjoy your life once and for all. That 5 days or 10 days you want to spend in Nigeria, enjoy your life. Please order for good food. Eat what you like, not what you see. There is no point in you waking up 5:30 a.m. in morning here in England in this deadly cold weather, and then you go to Nigeria and go and squash yourself in somebody else's apartment. Biko, Umba, please, Do something better for yourself. Think before you go. Get a diary and structure your journey yourself. Structure things properly. How you want to move. Structure it. Don't go and squash in Auntie Lagbaja's house, uncle, somebody's wife, my friend's family. Don't go and squash. God has taken you overseas. Thousands of miles you have traveled. You have spent so much money to come to England, get visa. You have even spent money and everything to get status. If you are one of those that have sweat before you got it, not someone like us that didn't work for it. We were just born in it by accident. We didn't work for it. So our case is different. But you that have worked tirelessly to get status, please, don't go to Nigeria to go and squash in Auntie Aderogba's house and Auntie Adekemi or Auntie Tokumbo's house. Don't go and squash in anybody's house. Because get apartment hotel, rent a nice hotel, rest, wake up time you like, and let them serve you breakfast, the girl self, if you like. Nigeria is a POS country, which means that you can use your debit card. Once you have a bank card in Nigeria, make sure the money is in the account. You just keep on spending with your card. You don't have to carry cash. They have done it in a way that people don't carry cash anymore in Nigeria. You understand? People do not carry cash anymore in Nigeria. Card, even buying petrol into my car all the time. I just tell them to bring me their machine. And I inside the card, and then they put the figure there themselves, because I don't know how to do their figure, it's long. So they do the figure themselves, and I do my PIN number. So Nigeria is a POS country. It is not a country you carry cash anymore. It's a debit card country. Just use your card. I beg of you. Don't go and squash in people's house. Go what's here? How much are you going to spend to stay in a hotel? Well, by the time you work tirelessly and reserve £500 for you, believe me, you will stay in a better hotel for days. By the time you put £500 aside, you will stay in a good hotel. Good hotel with a driver, with everything. You will have it yourself. Don't squash with people. Go what's here? Because they after a day or two, you start eating nonsense. They start giving you rubbish. That's the advice. I've never squashed with people because I don't have that spirit anyway. That's Bilodoyin since I was born. I never lived with anybody. I lived with my parents all my life. So I am a spoiled brat. I don't have experience of living with people. So that's why my independence is so important to me. I like to be independent without stepping on toes. Because when I'm on my own, I do things the way I like. I control things. I make myself happy. You know, and when I'm not happy, I get irritated quickly. I get scratchy. I get scuffy. You know, I get tired. So I want to encourage you, when you are going to Nigeria, especially those who are going first timer, get people, somebody on ground to get you a nice hotel. Let those who want to see you come and take you to where they are living and go and visit them like a king. You have struggled and suffered enough to get everything you have here in England. Go to Nigeria to go and live like a king and queen. Akiromo Bakama Rami Dansaki Lare. We don't see a prince or princess without the sign of palace on him or her. You will know. Yes, because when you stay with people, they get fed up with you as time goes on. And if care is not taken, you become a babysitter. They go out and say, Auntie so-so is at home, so you stay with her because you don't know where to go. But no, I salute Auntie Shade. Auntie Shade told me in Nigeria that she party like a mad dog. She told me, she said, listen, she's at Magodo, she party like a mad dog last night before she decided to come to me for my ordination. I am not a party goer person, so I don't mind. But I love to have my space, my independence, and enjoy myself in my own minimal way. You understand? So when you are going, ensure that you have put things in place properly. Omo yeyan, your sibling can betray you. Your sibling can betray you. Your sibling can let you down. So it doesn't matter who is helping you. They don't have to be your blood brothers. I still currently trust in Segun Oriluwa Benson until he will make mistake himself. And that is Yetunde's brother. Currently, I'm trusting him, you know, until he will use his own hand to make mistake. And when he make mistake, I will definitely know automatic, because my spirit will stop me from calling him. My spirit will stop me from getting close to him. And that is the way I work. So when someone trusts you, I beg of you, don't betray that trust. Trust is very important in any dealings in life. Trust, when people can manage to keep trust, you can go far with trust. Trust is very good because you can be distant from each other and be miles, miles, thousands away from each other. But when you have that trust, please believe me, it go long way. It go far. So I want to encourage us, those who are in the diaspora, because my science shows appreciation, trust, and belief. Don't forget. Appreciation, trust, and belief. So I have appreciate you all for you that have, you know, support me throughout when I was in Nigeria online, you know, to support me when I was doing going through my ordination. You know, I am now a chief. When you come to my office, you know, when you say chief, then I will give you the hands of chief. Do you understand? You need to know that I am now a chief. Because it's you guys that don't take matron job serious. In those days, our parents love it. One year, bad job. Baba, bad job. So matron is a serious matter. It's a serious case. And a matron must be very, very wealthy. A matron must have a good stature. Not in terms of my height. I mean stature, money, you know, status, connection, you know. So that when a man just cry on your neck, you should be able to sort a man jaw out, you know. You should be able to. They're going to have first wedding during my time. The CVC people do not know about this plan, but I think the group, the bride must have known about it already. They're going to have their first wedding at my time. So that first wedding, I want to do something different for the person, for the bride and the groom. I want them to know that they have a yajo. So they are the first marriage at my time, and I want to make it different for them. Do you understand? That's how it should be. That is how it should be. The work of God must continue smoothly. But when you come to my office, bear it in mind, Biko, I am a matron. I love you guys, man. I am a lawyer to the core, and I am a matron, a woman of God, and I stand gallantly to serve God anytime. What come may be, I stand gallantly. Lest I forget, I am not too sure, but I will be seeing the love of Christ people, either today or tomorrow. I should be able to be uniting with the LOC, because I've not been at Clapham for a while, but I will definitely be meeting with the Mama Handy person, LOC, love of Christ, you know. I love you guys as well. I love you guys so, so much. So lest I forget, it's most likely that the seminar will take place this Saturday, but I have not concluded, because we're supposed to be hyping it, you know. By now, we're supposed to be making noise on it now. But we haven't made that much noise. Omo Yoruba Tata, congratulations, my Prince Larry. I love you there. Do you understand? So, love of Christ ministry is on my mind now for my to deliver seminar. LOC at Clapham, Reverend Abimbola Esther Ajayi's Church. It's on my mind now. I'm back on the soil. Olushola, how are you, my darling? Welcome back and congratulations. Well done, dear. Thank you, Christina. Adiola, I love you dearly for your support online throughout the time I'm in my Lagos. Listen, I am a Lagosian. Come wealth may be. Love you, David Nigel. Love you. Love you, Diola. Do you understand? So on my mind now, love of Christ ministry at Clapham on my heart now. The next phase of my journey, LOC in Clapham. 412. LOC in Clapham, London, United Kingdom, SW9. That is on my mind now. LOC. Kudos to you, LOC. I am back on the soil. So it is most likely that you will find me, you will see me today if I manage to reduce my workload. Bear it in mind, I'm only arriving shortly, not long ago. So I have workload. But LOC for seminar to deliver, you are on my mind, on my chest now. I need to be having words with my mama's right-hand person on the event and planning issue. So if we are going to go ahead for this Saturday, then I will start taking loud. I will start bringing video out to loud it from tonight. I will start louding the video. But I want to make sure that we are going to go ahead because of my absences in the country. It could affect the advertisement because I want people to really turn up. It doesn't have to be your church. But I love you, love you, love you to come to LOC for that period of 23rd of September. If it's going to go ahead, I will let you know. I love your spirit as well, girl. I love your spirit. I love your spirit as well. There is no doubt. Do you understand? Congratulations, ma. I hope you enjoy your break. I do. There's no there's no doubt about that. I did have a good time. I had a good time in Nigeria. The people that I was surrounded with are positive people, are people with positivity mind. You know, I met many new faces as well on business level, but I take my time to think about the movement with them currently. So I did enjoy myself, there is no doubt. I ate good food, I drink good water. I don't drink alcohol, but I drink good water. I drink some of their minerals there as well. But I ate good food. Chief Mrs. Thank you, Olamajek. I love you. You always know what I want. Yes, now, Chief Mrs. Do you understand? That's how you should be. LOC on my mind. Love of Christ. You know, love of Christ ministry on my mind. I love you guys dearly. To be honest, I really can't tell what I can say, but I will create an event where I will have all my fans as much as I could get together in London. But I need you, travel agency in Dubai. If you are a travel agent in Dubai that you have contacted me previously, travel agents in Dubai, schools in Dubai, Nigerians that are in Dubai, I want you to contact me as soon as possible. Then the Nigerians that are doing ticketing and doing travel agent work and doing schooling in Nigeria, I want you to contact me as soon as possible. The Nigerians, the Ghanaians that are in Ghana, that are doing ticketing in Ghana and doing travel agents and doing other sort of student traveling overseas in Ghana, I want Ghana to contact me as soon as possible. So I want Nigerian Ghana Dubai to contact me. Nigerian Ghana Dubai, I want you to contact me as soon as possible. Ishe tibere niye, work have started. So if you are in Ghana, you do travel agency work, visas work, ticketing work, I want you to contact me as a matter of urgency in Ghana. I am waiting for that gathering. Thank you, my love. Florence Ipem. I love you dearly, ma'am. You understand? So, and if you are in Dubai, lawyer to make it sense. I was privileged to watch your ordination through a friend's link. It was awesome. More grace and anointing, ma'am. Lawrence, hey, lag. I love you dearly. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. That ordination actually took me by my surprise. It took me because it was like I was swearing an oath again. And that last time I swore oath was when I became a solicitor in the United Kingdom. So I sworn an oath to the allegiance of the Majesty Queen, to the Queen Elizabeth. I remember that fateful day when I was sworn an oath. You know, I was asked to swear an oath before man and God to Her Majesty. And that is what I am still carrying on. Now, that day of that day in Nigeria that I sworn oath, it wasn't Queen that I sworn oath to. I sworn oath to Obaye, Patapata on the highest, not to the pastors or the congregation. The hope was for God. So in my heart, I was feeling heavy Holy Spirit that saying that I have accepted your hope today. So it was awesome. You know, it was awesome. So thank you for reminding me, matron to God. Thank you, Adedoyin. Thank you. Thank you. It was awesome. But I will organize a thoughtful and diligent one in England for us to have an event for all my fans. I will loud it in a way that it will be great, and then that is where I will deliver what is in my belly. You will know me better, what I can say, what I can't say. The bit of talk I did at the church in Nigeria, I censor most of the things. You know me very well because I saw some faces on that day, and I see that not all of them are in my level of understanding what I want to deliver. So I control things, you know. I control things properly that day. I will not lie to you. I control things, you know. I did actually control things that day. So I didn't bring out what is in my mind that day about talking about relationship, so that they will not think that, oh, yeah, your team come on a couple call. Yeah, you're saying stuff. Because you know some people. Do it at the best, you know. But if you are in Dubai, please, Mrs. Regina Obalano, I want to appreciate you for your support throughout. I want to appreciate you. I love you, love you, love you, love you every day. Mrs. Regina Obalano, I love your support. Thank you so, so, so much, Mrs. Regina Obalano. Thank you for your support. You are wonderful. You are tremendous. And you shall assure me, those support online that I saw on that day, I will never forget names. I love you dearly. On the day of ordination and at the Thanksgiving last week, Sunday as well. I love you dearly. Thanks for the support. So if you are in Dubai and you are doing ticketing, please, please, please contact me. You are doing visas or you are one of those that are practicing law in Dubai and you are my line, you are my friend. Can you contact me, Dubai? Can you contact me, Ghana, please? Can you contact me, Nigeria, please? If you are there, please contact me. You know, we are moving higher, we are moving forward. Welcome back, Ma. Ebenezer, my very good friend. I think I have something for you. Opalema. Benisa, contact me. Oromanisha Fayati, you sent me to the Secretary of State. I thought you have traveled to Nigeria. I didn't know you've not traveled. But you sent me an errand, so I've delivered your message. I think I have a result back for you. You know. No, I didn't speak enough. Miss Ipeme. No, I didn't speak enough. I tried to censor things that I supposed to said on that day. Because of the environment I met myself. You know, when you are speaking, you have to do it within your... You have to look at the people around you. Alhaji Rasak, Sonny, kudos to you. Thank you so much, sir. Thank you. Oh, yes, definitely, no doubt in my mind. I censor things on that day. I didn't bring out what is inside me. I don't bring out things anyhow. I have to look at the environment and the people that's going to listen before I bring out things, you know. You as a speaker, public speaking person, you must be able to program yourself very well and change to suit the environment you find yourself. And that's what I did on that day. I do things to suit my listeners on that day. Stephanie, thank you. May the good Lord continue to empower you in the strive to help and assist your people. Welcome back to the soil. Thank you, Stephanie Sinosta. Thank you. They are my people indeed. Thank you. They are my people. Because Joseph was sent on a journey. So, and it has to be fulfilled. I know the Holy Spirit was in charge. I know I felt it. I saw it. I saw the video myself. They were very cautious of me going away on that day. They don't want me to be sent to the, to go. So they were very careful of me because I saw the video after the event. But I thank God for everybody's life and I praise God for everything. So I want to appreciate you. I want to move on now. I want to go into the real day work. I want to go and start my work. So we saw your dancing for the Lord. How was it? We'll miss you, Ma. I hope you enjoy Nigeria. Welcome back up. Thank you, Alaji. Yes, so yeah, be there, Mashamu. Sister, well done. Thank you. I did dance, you know. I did know how to dance when I want to dance, you know. It depends on the people around me. If people that are around me know how to dance, I join them straight away. But if they don't know how to dance, I don't want to surprise them. So I try to pretend as well, as if I don't know how to dance. And then I pretend as if I'm a kata, you know. So I have two ways of living my life. I can live like an akata, sometimes like a pure British. And then at the same time, I can change and then do the Nigerian Lagosian style. It depends on how people want it. But that day was Lagosian style. He wasn't a kata style at all. He was a complete Lagosian. Because I have some good ladies around outside. They were outside on that day and they were just fulfilling their mind with what they want to drink and eat in my car. So I did enjoy myself. I had a good time. There was no doubt at all. So I love you guys. Thank you for your support. Do we have people that want to question me on legal matters now? If you want to ask questions, let's take chance now and do it before I leave line. You know, if you want to ask questions that is bothering your mind on matters, legal matter, I'm here now. Let's see if we can take matters through and answer questions. Yeah? With the sweating too. Thank you. Thank you so much. So if you want to question me, I'm on 07908-628240. If you have questions on legal matter, I'm here now. I want to answer calls. I want to take calls now. If you have questions on legal matter, this is the arena to deal with it straight away now. Questions on legal matter, we are here now. That shouldn't be a problem. I am more than ready and capable. Let me take the phone next to me. Hello. Yeah, hi. Good morning to you. You are indeed speaking with me. You are. Yes, you are permitted to speak in Yoruba language. You know, I. Let me address my audience. Can you please pardon us who are online there, because some people don't like us speaking in Yoruba, they get cross quickly. Can you pardon us here? The client online wants to speak Yoruba, he does not want to speak English. So if you don't understand Yoruba, I will come back, I reiterate in English. Please, I beg your pardon. Just bear with me. You know, you're online for me, you know, so you need to bear with me, please. The client online wants to address me in Yoruba, so we will take it on straight away immediately from there on. So carry on, sir. Okay, go ahead.
Bon, dada. Yeah, lati o ti pe bi aju more than 14 months nso.
Okay.
But ni ijeta mo kon collect as ni pe awon ni di further documentation akoto.
Okay.
And ni ko to de bere, won pe ki ma won kokan wa bi cancel tax bill. Ki gba letter la to do head officer tabi GP.
Okay.
Authority pe mo gbe pelu omo mi.
Okay.
But idi ti mo ti ni problem ni ma. Emi ati iyawo mi ati nta lati get awon head officer. Lati collect fun record ma. Jiki wa ta den do mo lo explain for won pe nkan ti mo fe le. Won ni pe amu le ko run pe ben.
Okay.
Ipe nkan ta won kan le ko ni pe mo register pe lawon.
Okay.
Then be that place.
Okay.
Mo de ni limited pe lati ta kini e pada ma.
Okay. Igbawo ni deadline to fun yin ta ni lawyer yin, what is your lawyer doing? Definitely now, because they are
also one grant. Some of my refuse to me submitting because I want to do that.
Exactly. Exactly. So how do you want to go about it?
Because you minimum me with them because you pressure. But they need the next week to submit it.
Next week, Nanika is submitting a deadline.
Ben, ma.
Now, that is not, that doesn't appear to be legal advice, isn't it? Oda, I pay only the wisdom that you apply. And your lawyer should be able to handle that situation perfectly, professionally, without doubt. The document pending is crucial to the decision. In my mind, there's no doubt. Excuse me. Because whenever they ask for documentation, it means that they have your file is at the last stage. Your file is at the last stage, and I wouldn't want you to miss that opportunity. But with them, one opportunity lost, it might not be regained on time.
Exactly. You know? More than this year, so.
Can the documents do what pending now?
Letter to the head officer, tabi GP, tabi local authorities.
Can you tell me what you're doing?
Yahoo, tell that you get in touch with one who I went to be some respond. And GP, you know, they're waiting for lossy pay for us because the only pay that I only call, I only call pay in that common link pay, papa, me address you up for Yahoo. You pay the town for me, link pay, and we address you, and they register for that one.
So why did you GP actually mention story? But the GP has obligation to write a letter that you are registered with them at that place. I mean, he gets English writing. Do you understand what I'm saying? The GP has obligation to say that you were registered with them. Some of the charge you want to charge you.
Yes, the
Hold on a minute. You are speaking to a person who understands exactly what the government is seeking from your end. The government says that go and get a letter.
Exactly.
To show that you live in the same address with your son.
Yes.
So why would the GP say no to that?
It's not even clear to me, so I don't know.
Can you instruct your lawyer? Did you pay your lawyer to do the job, or you're doing it yourself?
Yes, he was paid.
Yeah, if your lawyer were paid to do the job, yeah, you need to instruct your lawyer to write a letter to the general practitioner and say that the government need that letter. And that's a crucial letter. Tell your lawyer to do a letterhead letter.
Okay.
Yes, I think that you should be given automaton. So the lawyer will do a letter. They have to write and respond before the deadline, because that's your chance, my dear.
Exactly, ma'am.
Yeah, so you need to push for it. Don't give up.
All right.
Mm-hmm. Good luck.
Ma'am.
No worries, my dear. Bye. Some general practitioner practice can be very stubborn in the UK, but you have to be wary of them. If you have paid your lawyer to do a good job, you must be able to instruct your lawyer what you want. If you don't pay me and you want to instruct me and tell me what to do, you'll be joking. You'll be finding a laughter because I'm not going to listen to you. People call me Jebu, whatever. Okay, so do a whole lot. It's just that a way of what you need. So if you want to instruct me, you have to instruct me with common sense. You know, when government is seeking for a document like that, it means that your situation is at the last minute for a make decision. No, the GP must be given, they must give you letter. When government said go and get a letter from your general practitioner, they must issue you a letter. If they're going to charge you to do that letter, that is fine. That is their prerogative. I don't get involved. But as for a letter, they must issue. There is a case that they were trying to prove stubborn with me at meeting kills. You know, I asked my secretary to use my letterhead and send and give them automaton to write letter to them. I said they should download me. They did within 3 days. Within 48 hours, I got that letter on my system. One, Tobe, when they see lawyer letter, they shake as well. Doctors fear us when it comes to asking for document and disclosure. Because the moment client has given us letter of authority, we will have that automatic power to instruct GP to release documentation in confidence to us. And that is why our position is a position of trust as a solicitor all over the world. When you are in a situation like this as a lawyer, you are in a position of trust. You must not betray your client. You must not let your client down. People are putting their trust, their life into your hands as a lawyer. So you must not let them down. GP must not let his patient down. So when a patient asks for a letter, if you are going to charge for it, GP, you can charge. That's your prerogative. I'm not stepping in that area. But don't tell me that you are not going to issue client's letter when they are seeking. They needed it. That's why they asked for it. If they don't need the letter, they will not ask for it. Please. So if we have practitioners online, please, can you just please make sure that you share it and let other practitioners know what we are talking about. When patient asks for letter from GP, GP must release it. If you are going to charge, that is your prerogative. It's not our problem. We are not stepping in that area. But you must issue that letter. If you want to charge them cost, I'm not getting involved in your professional issue. But I'm getting involved because you don't want to understand that you are holding an obligation. There is a duty of care. You know? Yes, there is a duty of care. So you need to understand. You know, you need to understand your position as a GP. You must issue a letter. And that position must not be misused. Thank you, Ms. Ipeme. Yes, now. The position must not be misused. Accountant, lawyer, and medical doctor, we are in a position of trust all over the world. And I feel so privileged and humble to be a solicitor of the Supreme Court of England and Wales. I put my head up at all times, man. And I will not let my clients down. Anyone comes through my desk, I will not let them down. Let me show you today. You know, this case now has now reached its toll. These are the four cases now. These four cases, this is why I tell clients from the beginning, you know, you can never see the name, so don't bother yourself. When I talk to a client, they think I'm joking. If I start your case from the beginning, believe me, everyone is my witness. It will go through successfully to the end of getting red passport in this country. If I start it from the beginning, every cases that I have handled from the beginning, I have never let them down, and the Home Office have never let me down, because they see me as constant lawyer on that record. So they follow case, they follow my story, they follow my representation on chronologically. This case, when we started, they have not even spent time for them to have discretionary leave many years ago, 2004. This case today has been granted indefinite leave to remain. what did I say? Indefinite leave to remain. The owner of this thing, they are coming now because they know I'm in the country now. So they are traveling down. Let me charge quickly so that I don't lose battery. So the issue here is that we must always understand one thing. To ba tin se agbere lawyer kakiri ko se agbere nkan ti o si agbere ijo wa agbere lawyer wa agbere ton wa. When you are doing agbere of everything, you are not going to go far with it, trust me. You are not going to go far at all when you are doing agbere this, agbere that. You understand? So you need to know what you want. If I start your case from the beginning, I can guarantee you that it will go to the end. Every cases that I have handled so far in this country that I start from the beginning, I see them to the end. Every damn cases, Timothy Bere, Timo Andu Nilu Yo, Mugwe, Mokpari, Mugwe. So the more you move around from lawyer to lawyer, the less likely to be successful with your application. That's just the point. The more you move around from lawyer to lawyer, the less likely to be successful with your application. Because they will be thinking that what do you have that you are hidden? You understand? If you don't have anything in hidden agenda, why would you be moving around from place to place like yo-yo? I'm on 07908-628240. So if you want to talk about your matter now, your legal matter, I am of help here. I'm at hand here before I start my serious cases. But I've got loads of work to do. Trust me. I've got loads of work to do. I've got loads of work to do. But I want to just take my fans' priority as priority first. Adedonyi, who are you? I'm so proud of you, Diola, as well. Thank you. Adedonyi, you know me. Adedonyi is even describing where my office is. I salute you, Adedonyi. I love you. Hello? Hello?
Hello.
Eh? How are you? Good morning, sir.
Good morning.
Yes, Ekaroma. Shall I feel any? How can I help you? Okay, go ahead.
Yeah. One applied last year. One went back to me.
Okay.
Off money first time. Tomorrow only off money 6 months. But they don't form me. I so we only do 9 weeks.
Okay.
But that one 5 weeks no look. Not that bad.
Okay.
So I very apply for one thing because about 2 years, but I feel they call you bill to man only by a third young woman, but yeah, I won't know me, our oldest pregnancy. So while I come my thing, they say I disclose it. If we should man no man, if we reapplication, but I fish for the pain to ring or by coffee assist at the Dorothy.
Poma low 5 months, but you need to have medical evidence to back it up that your wife has is in a serious situation and she needed her mother to assist for that period of time. And you must make sure that 5 months is 5 months.
Okay.
Yes. If you tell them from onset, you will not encounter any problem. But if you don't tell them from onset, then you have to blame yourself if it's refused.
Okay.
Yeah.
Benny,
you have to.
Yeah.
You have to.
Okay.
You have to.
Okay.
Thank you so much. Thank you for your back. We are on 07908-628240. We are on 07908-628240. Who is worried? Somebody is telling me I'm worried. Until I'm yet to get the letter from home office. Okay. Ekaboma. Okay. Good morning, Chief. My Chief Mrs. You will not kill me. Who is this? You won't kill me. Ekaboma. I will look at the situation. If you are one of mine, I will look at it. Don't worry. But if you are not mine, then you have to embrace me properly so that I can understand what you want from me. Good morning to you. Good morning.
Good morning, Bruce.
Good morning. How can I help you?
If you are one of mine. Hello, my helper.
But if you are not smart, then you have to address me properly so that I can understand what's going on.
Good morning. Yes, good morning.
Please go ahead.
Invite you, Monsignor, while I'll ask you later.
Okay.
but 5 years. But you know, it's a situation to move it that way. Can you understand, ma? Oh, so the money, there's nobody.
Okay, I can hear you.
So, we want to move it, shall we? Can you understand, ma?
Can you lower your own Facebook volume? Because I'm hearing your voice back again.
Okay. Yeah. All right, ma. Hello, ma. Can you hear me now?
I can hear you vividly now, yes.
Okay, yeah. Money 5 years. I'm talking about 5 years. Maybe by Bortori, because you know, really invite anybody, don't you with me? I understand. So, but Montreal, Latin, Boom, see me, what, but me, or Mumashelashi, just for visiting.
How do you mean that you cannot invite people if you have 5 years? What type of 5 years do you have? Do you think you want to disclose your... Do you think you want to disclose yourself in the public?
Okay, ma.
Eh?
Ma, I'll pay you later then.
Exactly.
Okay, ma. Eshema. Eshema, bye, ma.
It is well with you. Laya Tukumbo Lagbaye, good morning. Hello? Hello, good morning to you.
Good morning.
Good morning.
Yeah, I just want to ask a question.
Please go ahead.
I have a friend who's got a criminal record. So he's quite worried about the fact that maybe he won't be able to get a British passport because of that. So I told him to go on this and ask lawyer to come up.
Okay.
I said, if he doesn't want to go, I said, okay, I will ask and see what lawyer said. Maybe you can go through her to do whatever you want to do.
Okay.
Yes, ma'am. That's the question. If the person can still have a British passport with with criminal record.
What type of criminal record?
I think it's kind of housing benefit thing.
Does the case went to court?
Yes, it does. He went to court.
The case went to court, yeah?
Yes, went to court.
Do you know whether it's recorded? Do you know whether after the case went to court, what was the outcome?
I think they gave him this thing to do.
Community service?
Yes, yes.
I think it will affect record a bit. That was that's benefit fraud.
Yes, yes, I think that's what he said.
It is benefit fraud. And benefit fraud is as bad as other fraud. Yeah. If case doesn't go to court and it's settled amicably and the person is asked to be paying back, that is fine. But the moment case go to court, it's recorded. Do you see what I mean? It's recorded. So there is every possibility that it will go against the red book, red passport, issuing of the red passport. There is every possibility. How many hours community service was the person given? How many hours?
I think, oh my God, it's not too much. I think it's about... maybe 3 months.
But it's recorded. The crucial thing you have to note is that it's recorded. Do you understand? It is recorded.
You mean the case?
Yes, because it went to court.
Okay. So if it's recorded now, it's no need of applying for British passport.
There's every tendency that he might lose the money.
Okay.
There are some cases that you have to wait a year after when the situation, when the offense was committed.
No. The what they told her, because what they told him in home office, because he called them, and they said after 5 years. So it's now 5 years.
5 years of the offense?
Yes.
He can go ahead now. Okay. I thought it was a fresh case.
No. It's 5 years now, because he himself called the home office.
If it's after 5 years, he can put in application now. It's fine now. It's fine.
He can apply for it.
Definitely.
Okay. Excuse me, ma. Is it possible to give us your details so that I can come and see you.
The number you are calling is what you will call later on to book appointment. Or alternative, right, you can have 0208.
Okay, hold on, man. Let me quickly put that down for... Because he wanted to go through lawyer. I told him to go through lawyer instead of doing it by himself because of the record. Okay. Can I have the number, ma'am?
0208.
0208, yeah? 309.
8808.
8808.
Yeah.
Okay, ma'am. As soon as you finish this program, I will tell him to call
you, ma'am. It is well. The secretary will pick it up anyway. Thank you.
Okay, then. Thank you, ma'am.
Yeah, bye.
Okay, bye.
There are some offense that you would commit in this country and it will prevent you from having a red passport for life. There are some that you would have to wait a year, 2 years, 3 years, 4 years, 5 years. There are some you have to wait 10 years. There are some you have to wait 15 years. You understand? So it's not something you can just go into straight away and thinking that you want to apply if an offense is committed and it's chargeable and it's punishable under law. You know, once it's punishable in law and it's a criminal offense, you should know that it's punishable. So it will affect your ability, you know. It will definitely affect your ability because it says criminality under the immigration rules. Criminality under the immigration rules, you know. So you need to be wary of that, you know. And this criminality under immigration rules have, when you have been convicted of an offense for which you have been sentenced to a period of imprisonment of at least 4 years, or has been convicted of an offense for which he has been sentenced to a period of imprisonment of at least 12 months, but less than 4 years, unless a period of 10 years has passed since the end of the sentence. Did you see? So there are some offenses that if you have been sentenced to a period of imprisonment for at least 12 months but less than 4 years, from 12 months, at least 12 months but less than 4 years, you have to wait for 10 years. You have to wait for 10 years before you can get your, before you can apply for British passport. Now, in his own case, in that case that lady have just asked me, thank God to my brain under criminal law. That is why when you are a lawyer, you must be fully fledged. The sentence that the person was given was the smallest among them all. It was minimal. So it does not attract prison offense, sentence. It wasn't a sentence that attracts period of imprisonment. It was the one that attracts community service, which means that the 5 years is the minimum he can wait for before he can apply for British passport. Like I said, British passport is not for Dick and Harry anymore. Thank you, Susie Addis. Thank you. Thank you. We are in the United Kingdom. This person that just joined us and asking which country. We are in the Queensland, the Queen's own land. You know, God's own land. United Kingdom is God's own land, not anywhere else. This is where everybody moved from to go and establish their United States. United Kingdom is the king, and that's why it's the United Kingdom. You understand? So this is the God's own nation. Ah, yes now. Hello? Hello? So people need to be wary of that. This is where they moved to go and establish United States. So UK is the God's own country. This is it. This is where it's, nobody colonized the United Kingdom. No country. United Kingdom was not colonized. You have to look at the Roman Empire. And that is where you will accept supremacy, you will respect supremacy. We are in the UK anyway. Yeah, make joking, Jasha. Let me move on smoothly. So the period of offenses is crucial for anyone who wants to obtain British passport. So if you have criminality before in the past, don't just go and apply for your naturalization because you will lose a hell of money. You will lose £1,282. That's what you will lose. You will then lose the legal fee that you have paid your lawyer. So you need to be wary of that. I'm in the UK. If you want to contact me, I'm on 07908-628-240. The telephone number for office is 0208 309-8808. So let's do it this way. Book your appointment in the office here. Book your appointment to see me. Appointment to see me. 0208-309-8808. So you will book through that. There's an error with the, thank God I pick it up. So you book through 0208-309-8808. So that is the line you will book through to see me. Don't forget that I am just refreshing myself. I'm back on the soil. I don't know whether it's cold for you, but because I have taken too much heat there, as soon as I arrived, I felt that cold straight away. And that's why I padded immediately, because I love to protect myself in anything. In any ramification, I love to make sure that I'm warm. I have not taken my cup of tea. I'm taking the orange juice first, but I need to take my tea. So, don't go and put in an application to become a UK citizen if you have been convicted of an offense punishable in law and it attracts imprisonment. If it has attracted a period of imprisonment, I beg of you, you need to see me first. You understand? You need to see me and get it from my brain before you move forward smoothly. You know, you need to digest through me. Hello?
Hello, ma'am.
Yes.
Ekaro,
good morning to you. How are you?
Ekaro, ma'am.
Thank you so much. Thank you.
Yes, ma'am. I nationalization test for
you. Right.
Ti yon ba ti koko apply tele, te komo refuse yo. Right. So, mwisha ni problem on immigration to ekwa something like that. Mwisha apply biya bi 4 years. Koto afu ni niwe, ni 4 years. Mwisha tuwa no, another 6 years. Choma ka 4 years ni mwisha apply tele.
Can you take me through the journey peacefully? Iwe wo le rin fa si the red passport because, or the limited leave to remain.
No, mo apply. Mm-hmm. Mo wa ni lu. Mhm. Nipa e. So mo refuse me le meji. So mo after 4 years, so mo fire mo so bi mo. O se wa fun mi ni 3 years le meji. Mi se wa gba en defun mo a bi se mo le se 4 years ti mo ti ko apply e se o totally more 6 years four years.
Before you apply for your first 3 years, were you with status?
No.
So any status back they apply?
Yeah.
Okay. So in that case, if you don't have status at the time you apply, you will have to follow your first day of the application and count your 10 years together.
Oh, okay. All right, ma'am.
Okay?
Yes, ma'am. Thanks, ma'am.
Bye bye, dear. Hello?
Yes, good morning, ma'am.
Good morning to you, madam.
Yes, I'm just calling to find out something for a friend.
Okay.
I have a friend that has worked in this country for 14 years with nothing.
Mm-hmm.
But now he had to leave the work. Can't he apply for anything?
Can he do what?
Can he make any application to the Home Office?
Can he make application to the Home Office?
Any application, yeah.
And he has spent 14 years in the UK.
Mm-hmm.
They have cancelled that opportunity, so he has to wait for 20 years, so he's got another 6 years to go.
Unless, the fact that he was able to work, there's nothing he can do.
It's not supposed to work if he has run out of status.
I know.
So don't let them know. It's not supposed to work.
Okay. Mm.
Yeah?
All right then, thank you.
That's all right, bye. Hello?
Hey, Roma. Hey, Roma.
Hey, my car, shall I fear me?
I do, come on. Hey, your mommy, my favorite name. I mean, my red passport. My looking very quick. Tiba fetch a resident permit.
Mm-hmm.
So, can you imagine?
Any red passport? Italian, eh? Okay, how many years have you been living in the UK for?
Over 15 years.
So you can apply for your permanent residence, but don't apply for a British passport.
Okay. So you can apply to
it? Oh yes, why not, ma? Call my call my office and book appointment. No, you can't see me without appointment.
So our own document on the Makoa.
You have to come to the office for consultation, madam.
Okay then.
Yeah.
Thank you, ma'am.
Okay, ma'am. Those who know me very well. You cannot see me without appointment. You've got to book appointment and pass through my secretary to see me. And that's why my work is important to people that have gone through that procedure. You know, I take my job serious and my office very serious. If you want to see me, you have to book appointment to come and see me. Without appointment, I can't see you because I deal with a lot of people. So I don't want to deal with Dick and Harry along the line. So I have to be careful. Yes. Hi.
Hello, Ekaro.
Ekaro.
Yeah, at least no sorrow.
Okay.
Yes, ma.
That's fine. If somebody can get away with it, why not? Normally, by you invite him only, but case are pelu amo ibere ten be lori line.
Okay, ma. Ise na se le ba wa se pe a fe mo wo lati Naija wa sibi.
It's not a problem. Book up appointment to see me in the office. That's fine with me.
Okay, ma.
Yeah.
All right.
Okay. Thank you, bye.
Okay, ma.
You know my capacity, so when you want to see me, just book appointment and come and see me. Good morning to you. From which country is this? Florida.
Oh, hi. Yeah, I'm calling from Florida. Yeah. My name is Josiah Akintegi. I just somehow bumped into your something on the YouTube, and I was so much impressed, you know, by what, you know, the advice, the counsel when you were giving. The whole Nigerian people, not just only Nigerian people, but all the people all over the world, they find themselves in another world, in another country, you know. And I just want to commend you, you know. The other day I called you, but unfortunately I was told that you were fully engaged doing some other things. So you are fantastic. You're a great model, you know, not just for the whole humanity, not just only for a particular section of the world. You know, so I really want to commend you so much. You
thank
know,
you,
I was
sir.
So impressed.
Thank you, sir.
I was so impressed. Please keep it up, okay?
Thank you.
I mean, here in the United States, if you have that kind of thing, you know, the opportunity that you guys have, like when people have problems, it's being discussed, and you.
Okay. Okay. Carry on now. Carry on.
Yes, ma. Good morning, ma.
Good morning to you.
Please. I'm asking this question on behalf of one of my sons in the ministry.
Okay.
He definitely lived in the country.
Okay.
But when he applied for his British passport, they denied him. They said during the time he was waiting for the definite, he was working. He didn't supposed to work. But he wasn't aware of that because he was in the same job that he was doing before the visa run out and he applied for another one.
That's a serious offense. They're going to take it as a offense punishable, but it's not an imprisonment offense.
Okay.
So what was the response letter said that came from them?
Is to wait for another 10 years to apply. They say he might try to apply, but they cannot guarantee if they're still going to accept it or not before that 10 years.
It is not another 10 years. It has to be a continuation from the time of the first application.
Okay.
Go and read the letter properly. Don't misread it, please.
Okay. I will tell him to read it, ma'am.
Okay, all right.
Okay, ma'am. Thank you so much.
You're most welcome. Bye.
Yes, ma'am.
When you are filling application for naturalization, there is always a way to answer the inquiry when an inquiry raised on the form. So that is why you need legal expert. And when people are telling me that they don't need lawyer, they just make me angry, because there's no way you can deal with that situation if you have run out of visa before you start your first status in the country. Good morning. Good morning.
Hello, mommy.
Good morning to you.
Just a quick question. Based on what this guy said now, regarding
because in Koto Shele, what happened is, let me say it in English, because some of my fans are getting angry there that they can't understand what we are saying again. I don't want to lose them. I don't want to lose those clients. Those fans are important to me as well. Because what happened is that when there is an inquiry form that sometimes being sent out to individual clients for just the officers to pick up something about them, when they sent out those forms to them, God wants to have his way, because they refuse to use lawyer. They will do it by themselves. So when they ask them the period of employment, they stay the period of employment from the time they don't even have papers and have right to work in the country. So as a result of that, it goes against them. They think they are trying to flare it up or trying to show off that they have been working and contributing to the economy of the well-being of the country. But nobody asks you to do so if you don't have rights, according to them, what they are saying, not me.
Because I receive, the biometric paper that they asked me to go to at the post office. Mm-hmm. Then there's some another paper as well. Mm-hmm. But my lawyer said it's not. I should not fill it up, that I should not worry about that. So I just did the biometric alone. Then I've read it. Then it doesn't mention anything about work, because all the years that.
But if you. Moved for someone to say to you that you shouldn't fill in that form, because they don't just send out form anyhow.
Okay.
No, they Thank don't you. Send form out anyhow, you know. So that is just the situation.
Thank you, ma'am.
You're welcome.
Yes, bye.
If an inquiry is being raised by the agents of the government and you've been asked to respond to that inquiry, please, if you don't understand it, come and see me for consultation and I'll take you through the journey. Don't listen to a scenario that says you should ignore that inquiry. And don't fill in that form. If you don't fill in that form, you're not going to be granted your naturalization certificate. So you need to have that at the back of your mind. If you don't fill in the form that's been sent to you, they call it an inquiry form. It could be questionnaire. You know, it's different from feedback sheet. Feedback sheet is just an ordinary feedback sheet. I can throw it in the bin. Even me, when I go to court and they give me feedback sheet, I don't fill it in. I just put it there. When I'm angry, I just fill it in. I say, I'm not happy with the work today, you know. So I make complaint. If I'm not happy with the feedback sheet, I just make complaint. But if I'm happy, I just put it in the bin. I don't feel it. But if you are being sent an inquiry form, I beg your pardon, it has to be filled. If you don't feel it, you're not going to get anything from it. Trust me. So I think we need to have that at the back of our mind. I love you, Oluwa, something speaker at your crown. I love you dearly. Continue fighting my battle. God will fight your one at your crown. I love you. I'm on 07908-628240. I'm on 07908-628240. Thank you for those who are contacting me from Dubai. I love you dearly. Just continue to inbox me, Dubai people. Dubai, continue to inbox me. Ghana, please inbox me. If you are working in the visa, if you have a business like this, similar to people that are doing application or ticketing or other things in Ghana, Dubai, please contact me. I have been receiving some information about Dubai. So nice one from people in Dubai. Dubai, when you pick it up, yeah, please just continue to contact me, Dubai. I know one or two people that are working in a similar sector, like an agent and doing visas for Nigerians going to Dubai, have contacted me in the past and they are living in Dubai. Please contact me again. I lost your information. I lost the email you sent to me. I have some things juicy for you. So if you are in Dubai, just contact me. Nigerians that are doing visas for Nigerians going to Dubai, can you contact me if you live in Dubai? If you live in Dubai, contact me. Just privately inbox me. Because in Gatafi Pamolo Maniji, what you keep is what you keep secret, it's what come out good. So it has value, rather. It has value, you know. So contact me. Thank you. My number is 07908. Rara Umba. This is the number now. Please repeat. 07908. You know. 07908628240. That's the number to contact me on. Hello.
Hello, ma'am.
Yeah, good,
hello,
ma'am. Good morning to you.
Good morning, ma'am.
How can I help you?
Yeah, please, ma'am. I need 5 years in me at the
moment.
My first one is I'm doing less than 9. So more British kidney for show the bottom up with 10 to ba.
What status do you have?
5 years.
Everybody will say yes.
Okay.
Was the child born here?
Yes, ma'am.
Yeah. So could okay. Does the child have the same status you have?
Yes, ma'am. Yeah.
So either when you are going for your permanent one, the child get permanent, and then you apply for British for child the same way, like your one. Or when the child is 10 years from birth, continuously in the UK, then you apply for natural registration for the child straight away.
Okay, all right, ma'am. Okay. What's your mark when you get on a map?
Okay, all right, okay.
All right,
okay, dear. Bye. Bye-bye.
Hello?
Good morning to you.
Yeah, Ekaro, ma.
Ekaro, Shewapa.
Ekaro, ma.
Thank you.
Yeah, I'm going to be requesting for the opinion of my, thing about your tomorrow in the EU. As in,
as long as you are still with your person, you are okay. It won't affect you, so don't worry.
Okay.
It won't affect you.
Okay.
Hello.
Hello, ma.
Good morning to you.
Yes, ma. Hekaroma.
Yeah.
Yes, ma. Hey, Joma, I'm going to ask you a question on maybe nutrition status. Because I said, I'm going to ask you a question on 2013. How come to me, there's me a family. Maybe more possibly. So, apply next year. I have 3 years already now.
You mustn't, your status must not expire before you submit. You have to submit 28 days before it expires.
Okay, ma.
You have to serve your 6 years.
Oh, okay, ma.
28 right, days ma. Before it expire, they should have it on their yes. desk.
All right. So as long as Imasa has retained 5 years in UK, I can put in my application.
Mm-hmm. So I'm guessing. Enisuro, don't get it twisted. You were granted on discretionary or on residence card.
Permanent resident, because the one open by.
Was your application made under European person? And what type of status did your husband, what type of status has he got? Let's do it one by one. You're getting me confused.
Okay.
Were you granted residence card or were you granted 3 years discretionary leave?
3 years.
Discretionary leave, exactly my point. That is my point. That is where I'm heading to. So I am advising on that, on that basis.
Okay.
So you should wait and get your 3 years, 3 years together before you go in. So 28 days before your second 3 years expired, apply for your indefinite leave to remain. And you should be taking advice before then, because you will need life in the UK test and English language test and other things.
Okay.
So you should get consultation from me before then.
Okay, ma'am.
Good luck.
Okay, ma'am. Yes, my Shima. I'll call you there.
No problem.
Bye.
Bye. Can you lower the volume of your Facebook one, so that people can hear us here.
Hello?
Yes, good morning to you.
Good morning. Listen, I'm trying to ask a question. I have indefinite stay, and I want to get my husband in, and some people say you have to do an exam, and some people say there's no exam.
You have indefinite leave to remain, and you want your husband to join you. Are you with me?
Yes, I am.
Is your husband in England or outside England?
No, in Nigeria.
He needs to do English test in Nigeria.
Before he can get in. Okay.
Yeah?
Yeah, I'm asking if there's English test for him to do before he can get in.
I just said it now. I said yes.
And if I call you to book appointment, can you have somebody in Nigeria that you can recommend to help him to put his own papers together?
Book appointment, madam, to come and see me here first.
Okay.
You need consultation for something like that.
Okay, I will do that. Thank you.
Thank you, ma'am. Don't put in an application for overseas entry clearance without seeing me if you are in England. No, I think you should take advice before you proceed. Hello.
Good morning, Barrister Tokumbo.
Good morning to you, sir.
How are you today?
I'm very well blessed. Thank you, sir.
I have a scenario I need to talk to you about and see if your view is different, please.
Hmm. You want to share it in public or you want to share it private?
No. That's fine. I'm willing to share it.
Okay, go ahead.
Somebody would learn from it as well.
Okay.
Good. So in 2015, I applied for my wife to join me.
Okay.
So when the decision came, she was denied. So I asked my lawyer to appeal that decision. So it took about a year and 6 months for us to get a date. By the time we got a date and we went to court, the judge who looked at it said, at the time I applied for it, there was no tuberculosis certificate as at the date of application. Are you there?
Carry on, yes. Yes.
Okay. So he said as at the date of the application, the tuberculosis certificate wasn't included in the application.
Okay.
Then he denied the appeal.
She was denied?
Yes, she was denied the appeal.
Okay.
So we had the application. The application took about 1 year and 6 months for us to get an appeal date.
I know.
We went to court.
That could be very stressful.
Yes, the judge still denied that application based on the fact that at the date of application, we didn't have the tuberculosis certificate.
That's it.
Yeah. So my lawyer now said, but judge, we have all the documents right here.
If I were to be the lawyer representing you, I wouldn't have let you go to court because I know it will not succeed. They have changed the law. And it gets me worried when lawyers is not up to date.
that's why I wanted to get your own perspective, because I kind of, when I read it and I said to him, mm-hmm. why did you allow us to go to appeal?
Mm-hmm.
If when we have the tuberculosis certificate as at the date of the hearing, and it is now left for the judge's discretion, you know? So I said, it doesn't make sense. If you know from the one that we are going to be on the mercy of the judge in terms of discretion, you should have allowed us to go to court in the first place.
He should have advised you in writing and put it down before you and said, listen, this is 50-50 chance. You will now compel. If you want to compel to either, you want to proceed on that 50-50 chance. So he should have given you an option.
Exactly, Dr. Tumubo. That's my issue. Because I said to him, you know from the one that this is 50-50 chance. I don't like dealing on 50-50 chance. I need to be sure of what I'm doing.
Well, that's what you paid for anyway.
Exactly. So he said, okay, but so now we now went for a second appeal, which was 2 weeks ago. Because I asked him to apply to the upper tribunal I think the first judge made an error of law in a certain way. So he came back to say, yes, the judge made an error of law. We are allowed to go to the upper tribunal. So we went to the upper tribunal 2 weeks ago, and another judge was saying the same thing, like, oh, according to the law, if the document was not there as at the time of the application, that it's very dicey for her to allow this appeal.
Yeah. So you were only giving money for free. You were not buying time, because the person you want to bring to the country is not in the country. So you were not buying time other than wasting time and wasting money.
That's exactly my point. You know? So he just said something like, no. I think you allowed this to elapse. You know, and wasted the time and wasted the money.
It's unfair. But
It is unfair. So, yeah, I just wanted to double check with you. Thank you very much. Thank you.
That's fine. That's okay. Thank you, sir.
Thank you.
Yeah.
Have a nice day.
You too. Bye. Bye.
Yeah, bye. Yeah.
I don't want to stand in the way of any lawyer. But what needs to be done needs to be done very well. If you are doing something, you need to do it perfectly. You need to know what you are doing. You need to know the area of advice you want to give. You have to be competent, so that you don't step on client toes. There are some clients that they will not accept nonsense from you, especially when they have carried British passport for many years and they are acquainted with the system there. You have to be very careful. Hello.
Hello, Ekaroma.
Ekaro.
Yes, Mike, you must need advice, Ikoni.
There are files inside that are still pending that have been there for some time. Yeah. She, what type of application was yours?
It was because I've lived here for it's now 17 years now. I apply under living here before 25, is it 18 years or 25 years? Because I was there when I was small.
So you did it under 20 years rule, and was it?
Yeah, under 25 years, yeah.
Was there a lawyer that was involved in this? Was the lawyer involved?
Yeah.
Okay, 50-50 chance anyway. That your application is a 50-50 chance.
Okay.
Yeah.
Because they've already given me 2 years already. I've used the 2 years already. I'm just applying for another.
So you are not granted on that 17 years.
Yeah. They didn't give me because I was living here since when I was small to my 25 years of age.
Exactly. So you are how old are you?
I'm now 27 now.
Exactly. So they gave you because you have spent half of your age in the UK.
Yeah.
Yes. Yeah. Now, so you are okay. That's fine. So you just hang on for the second extension. There's no problem in that.
Okay, ma'am. Yeah. Sorry, can you tell me, do you have a branch in London here? Because I might be issue with my husband's case.
I'm in London.
Where?
I'm in Woolwich.
Woolwich, okay. Yeah. Maybe I'll call you then, I'll get the address. Yeah. I live in London Bridge.
Yeah, okay. So you just travel straight down from London Bridge with Woolwich Arsenal Station.
Oh, okay.
Yes.
It's very easy to locate because I'm...
Once you come out of the station, you just walk into my office. I'm in the commercial side of it.
Okay. How much is the concentration?
It's £50.
£50. Okay. Yeah. God bless, ma'am. Thank you so much.
Thank you. God bless, ma'am. The telephone number to reach me in the office is on 0208-309-8808. 0208-309-8808. I want to see if I can. I have work to start with. I have arranged myself for 11 o'clock start. So that is why I am giving you my time back, because you have impressed me. When clients impress me, I want to impress them back as well. So I am giving back to what you have given me to support me while I was in Nigeria. That's why I'm staying on for that long. It's not that I am not busy. I am very, very busy. I am a very busy woman, for those who knows my desk very well, you know. But I don't want my business to take me away from you, because you are part of the reason why I'm here. You know, I enjoy your questions. It helps my brain. When people ask me questions, I'm not selfish to disclose. Even when I was in the uni, when I was in school, when I was in the university, I share my brain, my knowledge with my friends, you know, with my colleagues. You know, I am not a friend carrier, but I share brain and knowledge very well. I don't mind telling people what I know. I don't mind. It's not a problem to me. I don't mind being selfish. You know, I don't mind to be selfish. I don't like to be, you know. So I like to share. I don't want to be selfish. So there is nothing taking me. Good morning to you, to share what I know. And that's what I'm doing. I'm sharing what I know. What is in my brain is what I'm sharing. And it helps me to understand it more. Good morning, my dear. Go ahead.
Yeah, I can't remind you. I'm in Yoruba, so.
My clients are getting angry online because they don't want you to be asking person in Yoruba.
But sorry, ma.
I will handle it. You ask me Yoruba and I will say back to them in English.
Okay. Ejoma, Ibatimode UK, but yeah, be 6 years ago, but October, you know, my pay 7 years. But on that journey, off my mommy, we have a position to hero at Sweden only 5 years. But me, more be much related to me, Timoli, really, to Timiba.
That is about Sweden.
One by me, she.
No, you're wrong. So, speak to my office, book appointment, and come and see me.
Okay. Thank you very much, ma. Thank you, ma.
Good luck. The battle will be a fair, very ten, very good. Where you don't get a key, Sarah. I'm a very ten, very key, Sarah. Be wise, my child. Be wise, my fan. Be at alert and be diligent in what you are doing. You know, don't get carried away. Don't get carried away. You need to be smart. You know, it's so important. You know, you cannot afford to make that kind of mistake. So you need to understand how to disclose information. Disclosure is very important. You need to know when to release sensitive information to the public at large. Some questions can be very sensitive, and that is the reason why I'm trying to control things in a way that it will not affect clients' interest. But at the same time, I want clients to understand that they are interest is paramount, so they should know how to deal with things as well, you know. I want to go and concentrate on my work now. I want to appreciate you all. I want to thank you. I want to let you know I want you to know that it cannot be done without your support, and that is why I say kudos to you. You know, no ramification. I want to embark on today's work. I want to deal with files and clients, physical clients coming in from 11 o'clock. I want to start seeing my client, and I think I'm going to be seeing clients till 6 o'clock today anyway. I wish I would have some break time between, but if I don't have. I am a workaholic, and I believe in work of my hand. and that will take me far with the glory of God. Dubai people, I love you. Can you continue to send your message, inbox me? Dubai people that are in Dubai, I want you to inbox me. All my fans that are in Dubai, can you continue to inbox me? I'm just receiving some inboxes, but I want you to continue to inbox me. Good morning to you, +49. Which country is that? You are from Munich in Germany. How can I help you?
Germany. Good morning.
I know you are from Germany. You are from Munich. How can I help you?
I'm from Germany.
Mm-hmm.
I just want to talk with the lawyer Tokumbo.
I'm here.
He's online now, that's why I'm calling.
Yes, I am. Go on.
Ah, Ekaroma.
Good morning, my dear.
I'm so lucky to be with you tomorrow today, ma.
Thank you. Thank you.
I'm boring for you, ma. Charlie, Tony Kamas or Yoruba. Yoruba Lawa had a brother of Yoruba. Tony Kamas or Lenu. And it's like Bury to Toby Funima. Sherry, our lawyers be what? Only put away your true, they shame put away your true. Kudos to you, ma.
Thank you, ma.
You know me, don't go. If I first time to marry, you know, if I am a woman. Even your wallon put down when you're true, ye talk on sofa when you're for so your phone, she sherry ma. So I get a war, a jacket to war silly. Hello, me left to go by year right away. Me know you but how are you? So by a pair to repair any client and I've been cocker. And when you need the book by advice, it's ten for ye. A shema. A mean by Jamie, me need advice you can bet. You mean do. I'm one of your clients, Shani Kinso. Me bad, right? But more love, Bobo Cotta, ma. I mean, Niger, I mean, more cock, where I mean, dance for the Lord. In fact, you know, one do. You know, me to be motioned in your long, my work, but you, ma. Along my that's your right, you bet you are belonging, you are winning, you are only one of my bad draft for
you.
I'm going to my shade at that, but look at them.
Thank you, ma.
God's my first son, ma.
Thank you so
much. I love you so much.
I love you too, madam. Thank you.
Thank you, ma. Love you so much.
Thank you. Love you, ma. Thank you. Thank you.
I'm from Germany, Munich.
All right, ma. Thank you. Bye bye, ma.
Bye.
Bye
bye.
Bye. So that is just like that. So if you are in Dubai, can you continue to inbox me all the Dubais? I know you might have been at work now because of the time difference. In Dubai, it's 3+3 hours in Dubai, +3 hours. So you are 3 hours ahead of us in Dubai. I know your time because I have been to Qatar so many times. So I know you are 3 hours ahead of us. The Dubai and Qatar, Oman, all those areas are similar time. So I've been to Middle East. So I know how Middle East is. But I want to encourage the Dubai people that are doing their visas for people there to contact me. Those are doing the hotel bookings and reservations. Nigerians in Dubai at large. If you're Nigerian and you are in Dubai, many of you have been contacting me that you want to come to UK. There are some things that I want to discuss with you. So just inbox me, especially those who have offices there. And then we'll take it on from there. I'll also send to Ghana as well. If you are in Ghana and you are doing the visas application to assist people that are traveling to United Kingdom or traveling to any part of the world, you can also contact me as well. Inbox me privately. And those who are in Nigeria that are doing similar things, you need to get it right. Our seminar will take place in Nigeria, and we are thinking of where to arrange it. A large seminar is coming to take place in Nigeria. We are thinking heavily where to arrange that seminar in Nigeria. The seminar will take place in Nigeria for all those who want to travel overseas or those who want to be working for themselves, who want to be doing the ticketing, want to be doing the visa. So there's so much opportunity for you to know what to do and how to go about it, to avoid mistakes and to avoid your clients being refused and being removed or being banned. So you will be given a major training. And we might want to take some of you, bring some of you to England to come and have that training in England. But it has to be step by step.
I'm sorry about
you. You know, good morning to you, Moti. Pick you up.
Hello, good morning, ma'am.
Good morning, my dear. Good morning.
Yeah, I just wanted to ask some questions.
Please go ahead.
Okay. I have just a small problem with these people.
Okay.
I put an application in to the home office, and then when they reply back saying that they're granting me outside of the European Union.
So what did they give you?
They only said they replied through the council that I was with, because I was asked by the council, by the local authority. They said they just said they refused.
They refused on what?
They refused on my private life.
How many years have you spent in the UK?
About next month is going to be 14 years. I have my parents, my father, my dad, my sisters, everybody here.
Well, what was the application was based on your private life?
Yeah, my application was based on private life.
And you are 18 years or 19 years, so which means that you are above 18.
Yes, I'm 18 years.
Are they making the application based on your parents to put you under your parents?
Yes, I make an application my parents.
When was this done? When did you put this application in? Could you tell me what year?
I did put the application in last year. This was in September.
Who helped you to put it? Was there a lawyer involved?
No, because I was under the local authority. They asked me, they housed me, so I had to put it through... I have to use it under the no recourse to public fund, and I had to use a free waiver, so there wasn't any lawyer involved.
Then you agree with me that you didn't meet any of the requirements, so the application was just put in for fun. Would you agree
with me? No, I didn't mess up any of the requirements.
You didn't meet them, that's the English, you did not meet the requirement at the time of the application. Met.
Okay.
You didn't mess the requirements. So the application you submitted was just for fun. It was just to just do something for the sake of doing something.
Right.
Yes. Because putting application under your parent as an adult does not guarantee success. The British law does not allow adult child to rely on parents, on British parents, for settlement in the UK.
What about between 18 to 25 years? What
between 18 to 25 years, we'll have to show that they have spent half of their age individually without relying on anybody. So if you are 24 years, you have to show that you have been in the UK for 12 years without break.
Oh, without a break?
Without a break, yes.
So a
break will come on being somebody who was sentenced to prison or somebody who has left the country and re-enter.
No. I mean, the 18 to 25 years one that is applicable to me, because that's one I applied for under the human right.
Are you 25, 24?
I was 20 when I came in, you mean, or now?
Now. At the time of the application.
Oh, at the time of the application, I'm not.
Because you said it was a fee waiver and it was done by the no recourse to public funds, I forgive them. If it was a lawyer, I would have speak, but because it wasn't a lawyer that did it, so there's nothing to say. If you need advice, find time to come for advice in my office.
All right, ma'am.
Yeah.
Should I just, the contact number details?
0208.
Okay.
309.
Okay.
8808.
All right, then.
Yeah.
I'll give them a call. Thank you, ma'am.
You're most welcome.
Yes, ma'am.
Bye.
Bye.
I'm here now. Hello.
Hello. Good morning, ma'am.
Good morning to you.
I just want to ask some few questions
please go ahead.
My position first. Hello. Can you hear me, ma'am?
Yeah. Yes. Go ahead. Go ahead.
Okay. Yeah. The problem is, initially, I was granted a leave to remain with parents of a British child.
Okay.
Hello, ma. Can you hear me?
I can hear you.
Okay. Okay. So now I actually applied for what's it called? Spouse family life was what I applied for. But they said as at that time I was not qualified for a spouse visa because I have not lived with my husband for almost 2 years. I've not lived with my partner for about 2 years and some reason. Mm. So they used their discretion and they gave me parents of a British child. Mm. So at the moment now, I've got 2 British children.
Okay.
And I'm ready to react. I'm trying to think, if should I reapply? Can I change it to a family life visa?
Mm-hmm.
Is that going to work like that now? Is there anything that works like that?
So how do you mean? Take me through the journey properly.
Okay. When I moved in with my partner, mm-hmm. I applied, I had a baby, and I had other children as well as at that time. Mm-hmm. But when I applied for family life. It was actually Leah that did for me at that time. I applied for a family life, and she said under the family life visa, I am not qualified because I did not meet the criteria. And I've not lived with my partner for up to 2 years. But they said, with our discretion, we can give you, as a British parent, we are giving so, and they gave me my 30 months visa.
Okay.
Because I had a British child at that time.
Okay.
So now I'm trying to reapply. So I'm thinking if I could change to a family that maybe makes the journey easier or faster.
If you have run out of visa at the time of your application for them to have granted you that 30 months, that is how it will remain.
Okay.
So if you have it, just continue to apply under your children. It gives you peace of mind. Quote my word.
Okay.
Because those are your children. They are not partners. So that gives you peace of mind than any other thing.
Okay. Now I've got 2 British children, and I read somewhere, okay, when I was trying to look for the things to do, they said if you have a spouse, a British spouse, and you're not a single parent, you're not qualified to apply for parents of a British child. So it got me confused.
Are you doing this on your own without taking advice?
No, I'm taking it. That's why I'm seeking your advice now.
Yeah, but you need to book appointment and come for proper advice. Do you think I can remember everything you are asking me in that manner? So I think you should please find time, yeah? Please find time. Book appointments and come and see me on one-to-one. Application to the Secretary of State is your life. It's about you. So you need to take it serious, please.
Okay.
Please.
All right,
dear. Thank you.
All right, thank you so much.
That's all right, dear. You see, there are some things you can't handle on your own when it comes to submitting to the Secretary of State. And I would appreciate if people can just take their application very serious and take advice first. Don't ask phrase questions online. These questions that you are seeing, these answers are general situation. They are not tailored-made. They are not specifically made. And I am more than competent to deal with individual problems on this matter, on this nationality issue. So don't get confused. You know, I am more than competent to deal with this individual headache. So please, book appointment and come and see me on 0208-309-8808. I want to appreciate you all. I want to thank you. I want to love you. I want to reiterate again. Thank you for all your support. Thank you for your tremendous support in abundance. I love you. I love you. I have to go now. Omoshishe le mi. I need to go now. Ishe luma endi poverty. When you work, it brings an end to lack of financial stability. When you have jobs and you have something to revert to, you have money to spend, then your status guarantees. You know, I'm not saying status to the home office. Status is you, what you have achieved or what you are achieving, your standing, you know, your wealth. Those things are so important and crucial, and I want people to take them so serious, you know. I love you guys. The love I have for you, I want to let you know that all of you, as you come on this wall all the time, you receive my love every time you come here. I will arrange time. I can guarantee you that I will have an event for Lawyer Tukumbo Lagbaye's fans alone. All my fans will meet together. I will organize events whereby I would like to give speech for free on that beautiful day. There will be foods and drinks on that day, but I need to get in touch with one of the pastors on ground so that we can use their church for the whole hire. If not, they will use my, I will use Church of England building, which is my church, to do the ceremony, as to do the event. So don't worry. I have you in mind. I will definitely give you back. Trust me. I will give you back for free. All my fans online here, I will give you back for free when I can manage to get the whole hall, the venue. I have sent my agents on ground to start thinking of how to move it on. That day will be a good day. It will be male and female. An entertainment for us will be around. We will have some musicians, but it will be majorly for Tokunbo Olagbaye's fans to come and benefit on that day. We have list of names and people on my profile, though there are thousands of people, but at least the hall will take up to 300. I will not take more than 300, 200 to 300 on that day. And it will be a good day for us. We will organize a lot of people who come and speak on that day, and we have several musicians around that will come and entertain you. Some caterers will be around on ground to prepare food, and I'll probably bring some people from Nigeria to come and feed you with what you need that is lacking in your life as well. So there are some good speakers around that I will bring them in for just loyal Tokunbo Olagbaye fans on that very day. Watch out, the day is coming, but it's not yet loading. We are just doing the underground work. I will get in touch with the promoters that will put things in place for us. But we are going to give seminars on that day, and there will be some musicians to play, two or three musicians on a different level will be around to play. And then we will have different kind of public speaking person that have a high profile in ministry and in other events, in other area of walk of life. We will get them on ground to come and speak to you guys, and so that we can eat from what they have been eating, that make them solid, make them strong in the world. We need people of caliber, caterpillar and caliber around us to speak. So we are looking for a church hall that is bigger to contain us. If not, we will take an independent hall. But they are mainly for Tokunbo Olagbaye's fan. That is coming up, and the loading will start. But before then, I want to start thinking about the Love of Christ Ministry seminar. But the date is like I am now not knowing what I'm doing because of my absences around, not in the country. So I need to speak to Mama, a personal person. And that is Reverend Bimbola Ajayi's church. Reverend Abimbola Ajayi's church in Clapham. That's what I'm referring to now when I'm going to do my seminar this Saturday. But the reason why I've not started loading it heavily is because of my absences in the country. So I want to make sure that things are still in place. So if I can, I will see if I can manage to see them today, because I'm sleeping already and I have work to do. Well, I'm sleeping already. So let me see if I can manage to get there today and speak to one of the Mama allies in the events and entertainment department. They are my guys as well. All Mama people there, majority of them are my guys. So I am not a stranger in that church. Anytime I can go there and service, I don't care. Anytime I get the anointing, where there is Spirit of God, I take it and I just move on. I try not to listen to gossip because I don't want gossip to disturb my destiny, to disturb my movement in life. So I want to take things as it comes. I want to be myself. I want to hold myself and be my Tokunbo Olagbaye. I don't want to be somebody else. I want to appreciate you. I love you guys so much. I love you for your support. God bless you all. I have to leave now. Thank you.